Did a software update just cause the largest global IT outage in history? On July 19th, 8.5 million Windows devices crashed, causing the infamous blue screen of death for airlines, banks, hospitals, and more. Since the crash only affected Windows computers, the blame was initially placed on Microsoft. However, further investigation revealed that the outage actually traced back to a software update from a company called CrowdStrike. So what is CrowdStrike and how did they have enough power to cause a worldwide Windows outage? This is Emmanuel Jordan with TechRepublic, here to explain everything you need to know about CrowdStrike and the latest updates since this all happened. Founded in 2011 and based in Austin, Texas, by CEO George Kurtz, CrowdStrike is a cloud security company that helps businesses detect and prevent security breaches like the Sony Pictures hack in 2014. The company, valued at $83 billion, has become a market leader for endpoint detection and response solutions for millions of security-conscious organizations. One of their main EDR products is a software called Falcon, which works by being installed on a computer system to constantly monitor for cyber attacks, malware, and suspicious activity. Because of this, Falcon is deeply integrated with the core software of the computer it's installed on, especially those running Microsoft Windows. With this level of integration, you can understand how powerful that makes Falcon. So, how did this lead to a global IT outage for all Windows computers? On July 19th, CrowdStrike pushed an update to their Falcon software that contained a bug not caught during testing. Through the update, the bug was installed on the core Windows system, causing computers to get stuck in a continuous restart loop, also known as the blue screen of death, which only appears when Windows encounters a serious error it can't fix. This meant that any PC, server, or display screen running Windows received the faulty update and crashed, which is how thousands of airline flights from American, United, and Delta were canceled, and how I ended up sleeping in the Atlanta airport overnight. Unfortunately for Delta, they're currently being investigated by the US Secretary of Transportation for the handling of the outage. In the midst of all this chaos, how did CrowdStrike respond? After realizing what had happened, CrowdStrike immediately fixed the issue with its Falcon software. After that, in a statement from the CEO, he said, "I want to sincerely apologize directly to all of you for the outage. We quickly identified the issue and deployed a fix, allowing us to focus diligently on restoring customer systems as our highest priority." Even with that apology, the next few months looked challenging for CrowdStrike. At the start of this week, their stock took a major drop by 13%. To make matters worse, the company sent out $10 Uber Eats gift cards to their partners. You heard me, $10. Only for the cards to be flagged for fraud by Uber due to high usage rates. If you were impacted by the CrowdStrike outage, leave a comment down below on what you experienced. To learn more about cybersecurity and how your business can protect itself, head over to TechRepublic.com. Till next time, thanks for watching.